So in this part, we're going to focus on immune responses in health and disease. So to begin with, we want to look at naturally versus artificially acquired immunity. So when you think about natural immunity, think about the fact that you've somehow been exposed naturally to an antigen. If it's artificial immunity, then you've been injected with something, and that injection has caused you to mount an immune response. Okay, now, regardless of whether it's natural or artificially acquired immunity, you have two different forms. There's passive and active. So what we're going to do is go through each of these first. So we'll begin with naturally acquired immunity. So let's look at the passive form first. So you have mom who gets exposed to the invader. So think about the invader as the antigen, and then mom produces antibodies to that antigen. So now mom gives birth to you, okay? So when mom gives birth to you, she passes her antibodies on to you, the newborn child. So I want you to illustrate in the graph below how you think the level of antibody would change in the newborn over time. So I'll give you a few seconds to do that. If you want to pause the video for a moment to have more time to think about how the antibody level would do over time, please do so. What we're going to do, and we're going to think, okay, let's look at our axes. Time is on the x-axis, antibody level is on the y-axis. So when mom gives birth to you, your antibody level is going to be high at birth, right? So you could think about time zero as birth. So that antibody level will be high. Now you have never been exposed to this antigen. So your body has no memory cells. It has no B cells to this particular antigen. So over time, that antibody level is going to drop. Antibodies don't live forever. So that's a passive, naturally acquired immunity. It's naturally acquired because you were naturally given those antibodies from mom because she was exposed to the antigen. Now we move on to the active, naturally acquired immunity. So an active, naturally acquired immunity, now we're going to leave mom behind. We're not going to worry about mom and pregnancy anymore. Now we're going to think about you, yourself. So you've acquired the invader. So you've been exposed to the antigen. And then you make antibodies to the invader. So if you survive, this is actually the best form of immunity. It's to get exposed to it and build up your own immunity to it. So now what I want you to do is to illustrate on the graph how your antibody level would change over time once you've been exposed to this particular antigen. So again, if you'd like to take a moment to do this, pause the video and then play the video again and you'll get the answer. Your antibody level is going to start off low. We're going to start off at time zero where you don't have any antibodies yet to this antigen because you haven't been exposed. Once you become exposed, your body's going to produce those antibodies. Remember that the first response, the first time you've been exposed to the invader, it's going to take you 7 to 10 days to make antibodies. So your level goes up and it kind of plateaus, all right? Now, if you get exposed for a second time, then this antibody level, do you think it will go up or go down if you get exposed to the same antigen for a second time? Hopefully you said it would go up. So then eventually this level would plateau and then eventually it's going to start to decline a little bit. Okay, because again, those antibodies are not going to survive forever. However, this is the catch. In active immunity, you have memory cells. So if you are ever exposed again, you can easily and very quickly make more antibodies. Remember, in the passive form, you do not have any memory cells, or plasma cells for that matter, because you weren't actually exposed to the antigen. Okay, so blood types are actually a form of natural immunity. And in lab, you have already experienced these various blood types. So be sure that you can go through and you understand how blood types are a form of natural immunity. And all the information that we did in lab is the same information that's here. Be sure you know this material. If you need some help, please come see me. Okay, so now we move on to artificially acquired immunity. So the same thing holds true. We have two different types. We have passive and we have active. So let's look at passive first. So in passive, there's a serum containing the antibody and you've been injected with it. So you've been injected with an antibody. You've never been exposed to the antigen, but you've been injected. So now please pause the video and illustrate on the diagram how you think your antibody level would change over time if you were injected with the antibody. So your antibody level would start off high, correct? Because you've been injected with it. And then over time, it would decrease. Okay, because again, you haven't actually been exposed to the antigen. So you would never make any plasma cells, you'd never make your own antibodies, and you'd never make any memory cells. Then there's the active form. Active is where you've actually now been vaccinated, and you've been vaccinated by the non-virulent form. What that means is this is supposed to be the form of the antigen that does not make you sick, but it does stimulate the production of antibodies by your body. So you're going to mount an immune response, and you're going to make antibodies. So now indicate on the graph when the first vaccination and when the booster was given. And then why should a booster be given? So we gave the first vaccination here. And then over time, you notice that the antibody level dropped and then it went back up. So the point at which the antibody level went back up must be where you were given a booster. So notice how much more the antibody level increased when you gave a booster. So it's a very good thing to give a booster. Okay, your antibody level goes up that much more and you produce more memory cells. Now we also have immune dysfunctions, and one of those are allergies, which a lot of us suffer from. So allergies are actually hypersensitivity reactions. And when you have a hypersensitivity reaction, you're going to have an increase in immunoglobulin E. Now the most serious consequence of an allergic response is the fact that when we have IgE antibodies being produced, that can cause your mast cells to secrete histamine.